My family, the New York Times, Vanessa Friedman, is revealing that Meghan, the Duchess of Sussex, has made a significant investment in a handbag brand called Sester Collective. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. I love this. I love this so much. I love this so much. My family, so while UK media are eagerly awaiting and hoping that somehow Harry and Meghan will run out of money, Harry and Meghan are busy working behind the scenes. Meghan, in this case, has made a very, very significant investment in my family, this handbag brand called Sester Collective. Now, my family, allow me to read you exactly what has been said by Vanessa Friedman, who also got the chance to speak to Meghan. My family, you know, kindly please hear this. My family, that Meghan Markle is a dolphin, not a shark, at least when it comes to investing. And my family, her latest investment portfolio is my family investing money in a handbag brand called Sester Collective. And that many things have changed since Harry and Meghan, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, moved from London to California. And the couple has blown up the myth of Windsor unity, had a second child, opened up to Oprah Winfrey, participated in a documentary on Netflix. And also, my family, Harry and Meghan, you know, as you all know, became tabloid fodder. And even to this day, UK media refuse to let Harry and Meghan go. They don't want Harry and Meghan to live and even work in peace. It's clear what UK media want. They want to force Harry back to the UK. And for what? To be unhappy? To be lonely? To be miserable? To be William's scapegoat again? My family, neither Harry nor Meghan are ever going back to that kind of life. Never again. My family, Vanessa says that depending on your point of view, Harry and Meghan are either champions of the battle against a hidebound, a racist establishment, you know, says Vanessa Friedman. My family, we all know of the racism that Meghan experienced in the royal family. And my family, you know, UK media have never ever been able to hide their racism towards Meghan. They've always openly, you know, shown the entire world how racist they are being and continue to be towards Meghan. So my family, I'm happy that Meghan now lives in California with her husband and kids. My family. And thing is, I know in my heart that my family, Harry and Meghan, living in the US has been good for them, good for their marriage, and good for their mental health. My family, Vanessa then says that through it all, however, Meghan's ability to move merchandise has remained notably high. Like that. So much so that in the year of 2020, Meghan decided to start putting her money where her taste was and began investing in a small portfolio of female-run companies. The latest is Sester Collective. I love this. I love this. I love this. I love this. Let me actually repeat this. So much so, in 2020, Meghan decided to start putting her money where her taste was and began investing in a small portfolio of female-run companies. I repeat, Meghan began investing in the year of 2020 in a small portfolio of female-run companies. Wow, 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 wow. My family, this has been happening since the moment Harry and Meghan stepped back as senior members of the royal family. Harry and Meghan clearly have been making investments. You know, my family, I have always kind of believed, you know, something has been going on behind the scenes. I'll explain. For example, the clothes Meghan wears, my family, I've always kind of known there must be a way whereby Meghan is profiting from the clothes she wears. Because my family, I could see her power. Even Tyler Perry said, whenever Meghan wears anything, it sells out. I could see her power. I could see her power. It's only now that we are finding out that my family, since 2020, more than 4 years ago, Meghan has been busy investing, my family, in female-run companies since 2020. I like this. My family, the thing is, so whenever you see clothes that Meghan wears selling out, I believe Meghan earns a very, very decent amount. My family, that's what I'm thinking. That's what I'm thinking. That is what I am thinking. I always knew Meghan must be making money in a way from the clothes she wears. Harry too. I firmly believe that. And my family, I love it. I love it. I love it. I'll continue. The latest is Sesta Collective, which specializes in basket bags that are handwoven by a collective of women in Rwanda and finished in Italy. Now, Meghan originally discovered the brand while online shopping. Now, my family, Meghan has told Vanessa Friedman of the New York Times, and I quote, I spend a lot of time just Googling, looking for brands, you know? Meghan said, my family, last week on a call from her home in Santa Monica. I have no idea what she says Santa Monica, because Harry and Meghan live in my family, you know, Santa Barbara, in Montecito, my family. So my family, but, you know, she says that Meghan said this last week on a call from her home, just after she and Prince Harry had returned from a tour of Colombia that was super, super successful. I continue. Meghan then said, and I quote, when people are online looking for things or reading things, I am trying to find great new designers, especially in different territories. I like that. I like that. When people are online looking for things or reading things, I am trying to find great new designers, especially in different territories. I like that. I like that. Now, Meghan wore a sister bag to a dinner date she and her husband had in May 2023 with Cameron Diaz, Gwyneth Paltrow, and their spouses. Afterwards, as photos of Meghan with the bag spread, sister founders Erin Ryder and Courtney Weinblatt Fasciano said they noticed an almost immediate uptick in interest. I like that. So my family, also what I can see here is that the thing is, UK media have been saying that Harry and Meghan have no friends, that Hollywood has ghosted Harry and Meghan. In my family, clearly Harry and Meghan are having, you know, dinner dates, my family, with other couples, you know, like my family Cameron Diaz and her husband Benji, my family, and also Gwyneth Paltrow and also her husband. While UK media says that Harry and Meghan have no friends and that Hollywood is somehow, you know, ghosting Harry and Meghan. You know, the reason why UK media are so hell-bent and desperate to paint this lie that people want to distance themselves from Harry and Meghan is because an abuser always wants to isolate their victim, which is what UK media have been trying to do to Harry and Meghan. They want Harry and Meghan to have no one to turn to but the people who abuse them. And that's why, that's one of the reasons as to why UK media have the audacity to go to Prince Harry and ask him, Prince Harry, can I come over and cover this engagement you and Meghan are doing in Colombia or Nigeria? Despite their bullying and abuse of Harry and Meghan, despite demonizing Harry and Meghan, which is what UK media have been trying to do for the past 8 years, despite doing that, they still think that they have the audacity. They still feel entitled to demand for access my family from Harry and Meghan and to Harry and Meghan. And yesterday, I spoke of how, for example, Carnival, also called expert Rebecca English, is attacking a respectable reporter who covered Harry and Meghan's visit to Colombia. Why? Because she saw better that when they went to Prince Harry to ask him, Harry, can we cover your event? Harry said no. That's why they're so, so bitter and even attacking respectable reporters who are given the honor of covering Harry and Meghan's successful visit to Colombia. So my family, all these attempts by UK media to try and isolate Harry and Meghan are all doomed to failure. It's all failing. And my family, we love it. We love it so much. Now my family, Mr. Erin Ryder, you know, the founder of this, my family, handbag that Meghan has invested in, has said in a quote, we were on our way to Mexico to shoot a lookbook. And we got off the plane and got our internet on. And all of a sudden, this one style that had been a little bit sleepy was totally sold through. And we were getting a lot of back in stock signups. We knew there had to be some reason that these were selling so quickly. So Courtney did some internet sleuthing to find out. My family, she says, we had more sales in one day than we've ever had. UK media, no matter how many times you try and downplay Harry and Meghan's achievements, you will not succeed. You will not succeed. You will not succeed. While Harry and Meghan are the ones who are gonna keep on succeeding. While Harry and Meghan are the ones who are gonna keep on thriving. My family, now that's the truth and nothing but the truth. Now my family, she, Erin Ryder, and Miss Courtney Fasciano wrote Meghan a thank you note, they said. And my family, a relationship ensued. And this summer, she offered to become their first outside investor. This summer, Meghan offered to become their first outside investor. I like this. I love this. These are the kinds of stories that my family I love so much. I love this 100%. You know? My family, look what happened here. The people behind this handbag, my family, wrote Meghan a thank you note. They said thank you to Meghan because my family, she bought their my family handbag. And my family, the moment she was seen with it, my family, it sold out. It sold out. And they sent a thank you note to Meghan. And Meghan, this summer, said, listen, I want to make you an offer. I want to become your first outside investor. And my family, let me just tell you more of my family what has happened. And so Meghan would not say how much money she had put into the brand or what ownership percentage she has. But Miss Ryder and Miss Fasciano confirmed that it was a minority stake. And Meghan said she realized how much attention was focused on her clothing choices in the year of 2017, following her and Harry's engagement, when she wore a bag from the Scottish brand Strathberry for a public appearance with him. A founder of Strathberry said the bag had sold out online in 11 minutes after Meghan was seen with it. When Meghan learned that the boost in publicity and sales she had caused had helped Strathberry expand its workforce, it changed everything in terms of how she then looked at putting an outfit together, she said. Meghan then said in a comment found that it is not that different from dressing for a role, but the role is her. Wow. Meghan then says, and I quote, "The times where I know there is a global spotlight and attention will be given to each detail of what I may or may not be wearing, then I support designers that I have really, really great friendships with and smaller up-and-coming brands that haven't gotten the attention that they should be getting," Meghan said. "And that is one of the most powerful things that I am able to do. And that's simply wearing like an earring," Meghan, then my family, you know, says. My family, I have a feeling, I've always had this feeling that every time you see Meghan wearing a cloth, there's a way whereby Meghan makes money from my family wearing it. I've always had that feeling. I've always had that feeling, my family. And if you're a designer, your biggest desire should be Meghan wearing your clothes or even family buying your handbag. Because the moment she does that, everything sells out. Everything sells out. And my family, I would not be surprised if brands have already reached out to Meghan. I've been reaching out to Meghan, asking her to please wear their clothes. My family, I would not be surprised. And that's why I'm saying that my family, I believe 100% that Meghan, you know, is making money from this. I believe that 100%. So my family, as UK media, somehow dream of seeing Harry and Meghan broke. Meghan and Prince Harry are making my family investments behind the scenes. And my family, you only know about it when they want you to know about it. My family, and Miss Fasciano said, and I quote, that Meghan's financial support is nice, but her gesture of faith in sister is even more important for the business. Miss Ryder and Miss Fasciano are the only full-time employees at the company, which has an annual revenue of about $1 million, its founder said. Its bags, which cost hundreds of dollars, are typically produced, you know, in small batches of between 25 and 50 units. And the weaving for each bag takes between 4 to 7 days to complete. And the founders say that they prioritize responsible production and fair wages over their profit margin. And now, with Meghan's involvement, Miss Ryder and Miss Fasciano are hoping not only to grow their bag business, but to eventually expand into other categories and to begin working with female artisans in other developing countries. And that Meghan's interest in investing in brands began during the pandemic, when lockdowns meant there was less opportunity to turn a Barazi moment to our own ends. Her first take was in Clever Blends, a vegan instant latte company. Now, there are between 5 and 10 brands in her portfolio, she said. And Megan, we'll only want you to know about this, these other brands, the day that my family, she wants you to know. Because the sad thing is, the moment when Megan makes an my family announcement of a company or a brand that she has invested in, the sad thing is that company or brand are targeted by the British media. As you all know, we've all seen how UK media have been targeting Harry and Meghan's commercial ventures. It is sad, but that is what has been happening. UK media wants control over Harry and Meghan. They want to control them both and even their kids. It's difficult to control them when Harry and Meghan continue to be financially independent. And we are seeing how UK media have been targeting Harry and Meghan's commercial deals, my family. It's sickening to see what UK media have been doing. But sadly, that is what they've been doing. And my family, UK media, told Meghan to go back to America, and she did. She now lives in America with her husband and kids. And instead of them leaving her alone to work and live in peace, they don't want to leave her alone. At the same time, they wanted to be quiet about her experiences in the royal family. My family, you know, you can't target someone's commercial ventures and then expect them to be quiet about what you have done to them. So I'm calling once again for William and Charles and Kate and Camilla to call off their smear campaign against Harry and Meghan and demand that they stop abusing, harassing Harry and Meghan, the Duke and Duchess of my family, Sussex. My family, now we know that Meghan now has between 5 and 10 brands in her portfolio. And she sees them as a complement to her own, my family, lifestyle brand, American Riviera Orchard. And my family, all of us are eagerly awaiting, you know, to fully launch, you know, so Meghan can finally become a billionaire. Just like she was always meant to be. My family, Meghan then says, and I quote, "Investing in them has helped her line up for this chapter where she is investing in herself. She thinks of her modest venture capital initiative as Dolphin Tank, as opposed to Shark Tank," she added, "and these are friendly waters." So my family said, Meghan has said. So my family, Meghan is playing it safe. Meghan is playing it safe. And my family, she wants to grow with the brand from the ground up. She wants to build this brand from the ground up. And my family, with Meghan's name and influence, my family, just know this brand will be worth 3 or 5 times more than it is already worth right now. Of that, my family, I'm very, very confident and sure of. And once again, also, it is worth noting that my family, for a long time, Meghan continues to be supporting other women. That's what Meghan keeps on doing, my family. And we thank her so much for what she keeps on doing. Meghan is a remarkable human being. Meghan is a remarkable, remarkable human being. And my family, anyway, whereby we can support Meghan, will always be there to support Meghan fully. And my family, the Meghan effect is always very, very real. Everything she wears sells out, just like Tyler Perry said. And my family, I've always wanted to see Meghan fully harness that power. That's why, personally, I feel excited, really, about Meghan's American Riviera Orchard. Because I want to see Meghan harness fully the power and influence that we all know she has to make $1 billion for herself. That way, in the future, Archie and Lilibet my family will never ever have to depend on William or William and Kate's kids for anything. That way they, Archie and Libet, have a secure future. And also never ever become scapegoats for William and Kate's kids, like how UK media and William and Kate want Archie and Lilibet to become scapegoats for their kids. William and Kimbleton is never going to happen. Never going to happen. You will never ever do to Archie and Lilibet what you've done to Harry and Meghan. My family, you know, I love that Meghan is investing in herself. Meghan, we've always believed in your power. We've always known your power. I've always known your power. And one thing I've always desired is to see you harnessing that power. You know, that's what really, you know, I want to keep on seeing. I want to see Meghan harnessing the power that I know she has. And that's why even I am more excited about this so much, you know. My family, someone even said that, you know, Meghan is one smart duchess. She knows that everything she wears sells out in minutes. So why not invest in the brands you sport? I loved the bucket bag she wore last year, but it sold out and was on back order. Let me see if it's restocked. Someone else, my family, says that. My family, we all know of Meghan's power. And my family, we want to see Meghan harnessing the power that my family she has. You know, the thing is, whenever Meghan is working on something or even engaging in a commercial venture, the first thing that comes to mind to Wikimedia is all the money going to charity? My family, how did Meghan do enormous charity work? At the same time, they also have bills to pay. They also have bills to pay. And the reason why Wikimedia keep asking, is that money going to charity? Is because they want Harry and Meghan not to earn a penny. They want Harry to be dependent on powerful money. They want Meghan also to be begging, to be begging. That's what they want to see Meghan doing, begging. And my family, Meghan will never ever do that. Never. Never ever do that. They'll never ever beg Charles for anything. Not after the hell they have put her through. The only thing that Meghan ever begged Charles for is for him to protect his own son, Harry. Which Charles refuses to do. But Charles is showing Prince Harry even his own true colors. Charles is showing Harry, you know, his true colors. The man family, he has never ever cared for Prince Harry. He only cares about him if he can use him. And I'm sure that Prince Harry already knows that. And also will never allow himself to be taken advantage of by Charles. My family, I love that Meghan is investing in herself. I like this so much. I like this so much. And Meghan, we wish you all the best success in the world. Meghan, we love you. Meghan, we want to see you thriving. Meghan, we want to see you living your best life ever, Meghan. We love you. We support you. And just know, Meghan, that we stand with you always and forever. Meghan, we are with you. You know, someone else said that I love this woman, Meghan. You know, she's one smart cookie. Good luck with the endeavors. Meghan, we are with you. Meghan, we are with you. Someone else said that when you walk the walk and not just talk the talk. Beautiful, intelligent, and well-spoken. Indeed, my family, she is very much well-spoken. And my family, when I see Harry and Meghan thriving and living the best lives ever, my family. I am sure also that Prince Harry himself also has made several investments. And my family, we want to see Harry and Meghan keep on flourishing and living the best lives ever. My family, I believe I have said enough. You tell me kindly your thoughts about what we have discussed. I want to hear from family. May God bless you all and stay tuned to our next video. Love you always and forever. And may no weapon formed against Harry, Meghan, Archie, and also Lilibet, Diana ever prosper, my family. May God bless you all and stay tuned to our next video. Love you always and forever. And also, one more thing before I forget. Just one more thing. My family, UK media, always say that they know what Harry and Meghan are doing behind the scenes. That they know of Harry and Meghan's plans. But apparently, they had no idea that Meghan already has, my family, invested in up to 5 to 10 brands. And they have no idea what these brands are. that Megan has invested in my family. But they tell you, sources close to Megan, insiders, actual staff, people who've worked with Harry and Meghan have said this and that. My family, I'm sure you can media, if they knew anything about Meghan, my family, already they would have known that Meghan has invested my family, you know, in up to 5 to 10 brands. My family, they know nothing. They know nothing about what Meghan is working on. They know nothing about the companies that Meghan has invested in. They only find out when Meghan and Harry want people to know. Because Harry and Meghan know that UK media are hell-bent in sabotaging their plans. And they're doing it follow the orders of William and Charles. So shame on William and Charles for continuing to target Harry and Meghan's commercial ventures. They need to learn to accept that Harry and Meghan are free. And just leave them alone. Leave them alone. Let Harry and Meghan live and work in peace. Once again, stay tuned to this video. Love you. Awesome forever. And may God bless your family. UK media know nothing about what Harry and Meghan are doing or what they're working on. My family, stay tuned to our next video. Love you always and forever. Hello, members of Zesco Family TV. First of all, I want to say thank you for all your support that you give us to our channel. We don't take it for granted that you support this channel. I want to say thank you from the bottom of our hearts for lending out your support and fighting against injustices, supporting Prince Harry and Meghan, showing them love. Love will always triumph over evil, and for that I say thank you. Good will always prevail over bad. Thank you so much for all your support. Thank you so much for joining this community, this amazing community of Zesco Family TV. I love you so much, family, from the bottom of my heart. And I wish you all the best. May you have a great, great day. And I hope that you enjoyed this video and learned a lot of things. With that and so much more, stay tuned to our next video. Leave a comment below, like, and subscribe. Love you, family, always and forever. Sayonara.